Hello, I'm Ben Brownlee for Boris FX, and in this tutorial we're going to be taking a quick look about how we can improve our keying using Boris FX Continuum and DaVinci Resolve. And here's the final shot that we're going to be working on today. Now, when we're doing this sort of keying for presenters over a background or like a shoulder set, the actual mechanics of the keying that we're doing is a little bit different than if we were creating a fully fledged keying shot for VFX, like a highly detailed key. But that's not to say that we should compromise on the quality just because we're doing this type of shot as opposed to a full composite. Here's the original shot. You can see that the key itself, or the background itself, is not the most even that we possibly could dream of. Got a little bit of set that we need to remove, but that's not a problem. And the other thing we've got is, if we take a look around about here, is we've got quite a good amount of motion blur when the hands are moving. Now, this is very obviously very common in these types of situations. In fact, I'd say it's more common than not to have a good amount of motion blur. And what I see constantly is people trying to overkey these sorts of areas. So they try to take out every little bit here and it ends up giving us a sort of weird kind of claw hand, or even worse, in my opinion, compromising the quality of the fine details like hair. And I've actually done our first primary key. I've used Resolve's own 3D keyer. I could have done this with the Continuum Primat Studio, but that's got a lot of the stuff that we're going to be looking at already built in. So that kind of felt a little bit like cheating. So what I'm going to do is just show you how we can take this 3D keyer and try and make this one better. So we'll take a look at this on gray. This is the final key that I've done. I've tried to keep in things like the hair. I've also kept in, if we have a little look here, some of the motion blurred edges as well. And we can see that sort of shining in green now. So we need to figure out a way of improving these edges. Now, the green itself is actually fairly straightforward to get rid of. Resolve's 3D keyer has a despill built directly into it. So if we take a look at the despill, that sort of sucks that green out there. There we go. So no more green. What it leaves us with, though, is a slightly dark edge around our mat. And this is less than good. Okay, so let's see this, change the output. I'm going to see this back in the final composite. Now, I know that at this stage, a lot of people's first thoughts are to come in to the matte finesse and try and clean up things like clean up the black, just to pull that in a little bit. Oh, hang on a second. I'm going to come in. I'm going to go up to playback and I'm going to turn off my smart render caching. We're going to be doing too many small changes for it to be able to keep up with the cache here. Yeah, so we can come in and we can try and clean this up with a clean black. And that does take away some of that black edge, but it also compromises our hair a little bit too much. So let's do this without touching our matte finesse. I'm going to come over to my effects and come over to my filters, and I'm going to search for BCC Plus Edge Composite. And let's drag that over the top here and open this one up. So what the Continuum Edge Composite filter does is it lets us do color correction and blurring, but only on the edge of the mat. So if I take a look at the view, we can have a look at our regular mat. So this is our mat, and we can take a look at our edge. We can change the size of the edge up here. But how do we know how big we want the edge to be? Well, this is fairly straightforward. Let's come to our output. What I'm going to do is I'm going to change my saturation and bring that all the way up to 200. I'm going to take my brightness, bring that all the way up to 100. And let's come up to our viewer and we'll just zoom into 100%. Scroll around a little bit there. Now come in on this size. So this is the edge size. And I can bring that up. You can see where the edge starts changing. that's where our edge is going to be effective. So what I'm looking for is I'm looking for how big we actually need this edge to be. With an edge width of about 7, I'm now taking this all the way in to that sharp edge on the arms down there. And I think this is going to be fine. So now we know how big our edge needs to be, let's take the saturation and brightness back down to 0 and actually do the real work. Okay, so the first thing we're going to change is the temperature. Always come down to the temperature first. And what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to match that edge temperature to the color of the skin that we've already got. So bring that round about there. Now this looks a little bit oversaturated. So what do we do? Well, let's come to the saturation. Bring our saturation down. Not too far. And I'm going to say this many, many times. It's always a case of balance. Everything we do is going to be affecting, you know, other areas. So we need to balance this out a little bit. So let's take a look at our before and our after. That's starting to look like something. I might take the contrast down a little bit here and bring the gamma up, finding that balance without giving us like too, if I take the gamma too far up, look at that, we get a halo around it. We don't want that. We just want to get that nice and natural. So now if I turn my edge composite off, where we did have a nice black line going around the mat, if I turn it back on again, that black line is pretty much gone. It's softened out. You know, there are still going to be areas. We take a little look here where the motion blur is really big. And we might, you know, we might see this area a little bit there because this is going beyond the edges that we're actually affecting. So we sort of weigh up our little compromise there. You know, are those small areas going to be more visible than the majority amount of time where people are going to be watching something that's a little bit static? Okay, so the other thing that we can do to try and help some of the colors on our edges is to use a light wrap. And we have the Continuum light wrap over here. Now, light wrap works a little bit differently in Resolve in the edit page, because normally you have a choice of looking at the background layer or a solid color. But because of a host limitation, the Resolve edit page doesn't let us actually look at the background layer itself. So I'm going to choose solid color. And under my wrap color, I'm going to come in and I'm going to pick something from my screen. So something around about there. Yeah, okay. And let's change our view to wrap on black and let's zoom into 100%. So what light wrap is doing is it's taking that solid color and it's applying it to the edge of the keyed clip. And really we have a couple of options. We can change the lightness, we can change the width, and we can change the apply mode. So if I bring the width all the way up, or if I bring the width up a lot more, it's probably best we just set this to fit. You can see this coming in and eating away at the edge a little bit there. That's about 36. We're going to get a really big, deep light wrap. It's not necessary to get this sort of wired on it, but I just want to show you what this is doing. And I can change my blend mode here. So we got the, you know, we got the standard ones there. Usually, if it's on a lighter background, you'll choose lighten or screen. If it's on a darker background, you'll choose darken or multiply. That's pretty much it. I'm going to try screen on this just to make it look as if we're getting, you know, light reflected from the background. We're getting that light bounce coming in. And this looks pretty wild. I mean, this is a lot of stuff going on. So I'm going to take my mix with original and I'm going to start turning that up. I'll probably set this around about 2/3 of the way up. So we're mainly getting the original, but we're just getting an idea of that light wrapping back around. And I think that helps. And the advantage of doing it this way is that because we're just dealing with the colors, we're not compromising the quality of the key. So we're not sort of getting rid of, you know, any sort of fine details that we've kept in. We're just helping it sit a bit easier in the composite. And if you don't want it touching the face, pretty much every Continuum filter has the pixel chooser built directly into it, which is a way of limiting where the effect goes. So I can turn my pixel chooser on. There we go. And I can set this to be a rectangle shape. Let's take a little look here. Turn my overlays on in the viewer. And I can now have that. Let's just view that matte mask. And I can now have that so it's only affecting the body, not affecting the face. Let's get a nice little soft feather over the top of it. Turn that off there. Turn off my overlays in the viewer. And we take a little look. It's only affecting the body, not affecting the face. So we'll take a look at the before, where we have just our keyed image with a sharp black edge going around the whole thing. And then with the Continuum Edge Composite and with the Light Wrap. And now to play this back, let's turn my Smart Cache back on so we can see how this is going to work in real time. And we'll play that back now. And that's looking pretty good. So hopefully you can see that the secret to getting better keys isn't to spend more time in the keyer. It's actually to spend more time looking at the colors in your edges, because that's going to help fix the relationship between the foreground and the background and give you better results. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects, and I will see you in another Resolve tutorial very soon. If you've enjoyed this tutorial and you'd like to see more about Resolve or keying, then be sure to hit the like button on this video, and likewise, leave us a comment down below to let us know what we're doing right or wrong. If you'd like to download a free trial version of Continuum, then head on over to borisfx.com.